Hey guys, JC here once again with a painting of Charlie. So here we go, starting off with clear water around the face and then putting in some Jane's gray and azo green, a little bit of quin rust on the bottom left, and then I'm just softening the edges. That's why I put some water down at the beginning, because I want to give this dog a kind of a halo, a glow all around his face. I wanted to darken the bottom left here a little bit, so I put some Moonglow in its beautiful granulating color that has a lot of separating pigments in it. Well, a couple of separating pigments. And then, of course, the main layer of the dog is buff titanium, which is a wonderful color. It's like sand or bread. It's kind of warm without actually being yellow. A little bit of magenta in to give the dog that fleshy color, because the dog is white and a white dog often has a kind of a skin tone showing through. So I did put some quinacridone rust in the corners of the mouth because the dog has that staining, and some cobalt violet, which gives the dog the shadowy effect. Now, right in with the nose, Jane's gray and Payne's gray, which is almost like black, but not black. It has a bluish tinge to it. So I'm putting my deepest values in on the nose, and as you'll see soon enough, also the eyes. I'm being very delicate around the mouth here because I do not want to cover up too much of those white hairs. A little manganese blue, which is a sky color that is reflected in a lot of dogs' fur, and this dog happens to be outside, so you are going to see, even though he's a white dog, a lot of different colors. And I did put this sky color in his eyes with some sepia, Jane's gray, and again Payne's gray. Again, carrying the sepia over into the shadowiest parts of the ears and the jawline. And the collar is, again, using the same colors, along with ultramarine blue. Just doing a little subtle adding of shadows. Here is this wonderful color known as palette gray, which is just a really light mix of all the colors that happen to be on your palette at that point. And of course, with a lot of water. Now, here I'm going in and I'm doing lifting. Now, this is how I get the white on dark. I don't actually use white paint. As long as I'm not using staining colors, I can lift them with my brush with a little bit of water and tissue. So when you see my left hand going across the screen going dab, 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 it's because I'm going with some clear water and then lifting it out with the tissue. When you do this technique, you do have to make sure that you don't wait too long after painting it. Like, I wouldn't wait a whole day. I would maybe just a couple of hours before trying to do the lifting. This is a very delicate part of the dog's face. The mouth, the muzzle has all these beautiful, beautiful hairs, and it requires a really light touch so that the mouth doesn't begin to look scary, I want to say. It's a very sensitive part of a dog. Right, so that's it. And once again, thanks for watching. I hope you found that enjoyable and somewhat useful.